So, hello everyone, this is score for this round 7:15. This is the first problem. So here what is given, we have three type of pawn songs like A, B and C. So we have to minimize the, Lunting will performing two concerts. We have to minimize the difference between the minutes. Okay, so we are given three type of songs A, B and C, 1 minute, 2 minute and 3 minute. So there are three possibility that this is odd or even. This is odd or even. If it is even, so we will distribute evenly. If even, all are even, we distribute evenly. And if anyone is odd, like if this one is odd, so difference will be one. And if this is odd, then difference is 2, and if this one is odd, then difference is 3. Okay, so if this is odd, then we will try to make like this one will be one concert has 3 minutes more, so we will try to make, and this is odd, this is even, then so what we will do is we will make here 2 songs of 2 minutes, then here will be minute, more minutes will be 4, so difference will be 1. So if we take all the possible cases, like this is odd and this is odd, this odd and this is odd, and all evens, like there are only 6 possibilities, so then we will all take, then we will find that if total minutes, like if we just go with the total minutes, if total minutes is odd, then difference is 1, and if it is total minutes is even, then difference is 0. This is the solution of the first problem. Let me see you my solution. This is my solution. I'm just taking the sum of all the minutes, and if it is even, then answer will be 0. If it is odd, answer will be 1. Now this is the second problem. So what we given, we have to calculate how many we have an array A. We have an array A whose sum is total sum, like summation of A of I from 1 to n, summation is equal to S. So we have to find the how many arrays, subsequence whose sum is equal to S minus 1. So we will get only at one condition, S minus 1, if in the array we have an element A of I that is equal to 1. Okay, yeah, so we will count how many of the elements in the array whose value is 1, and that much will be the array, that much will be the array. And another one is, if we have A of I is equal to 0, like if we have A I is equal to 0, then it will not affect the sum. So we will take this one I will take this element, or I will don't take this element, this will don't affect our sum. So the answer will be 2's power how many element A of I is equal to 0 into how many of element value is 1, whose value is A of I is equal to 1. Yeah, that's the answer. So like this is many people say how it is 2's power A of I, or how many of 0 is 1. टूज पावर लाइक फॉर ईच एलिमेंट, लाइक वी हैव 10 एलिमेंट्स, सच दैट ए ऑफ आई इज इक्वल टू 0, देन देर आर ओनली टू पॉसिबल कंडीशन, लाइक वी विल टेक इट और डोंट टेक इट. इन बोथ द कंडीशन द सम ऑफ द सब सिक्वेंस विल डोंट इफेक्ट. सो वी हैव टूज पावर एक, टूज पावर हाउ मेनी, काउंट ऑफ वन, काउंट ऑफ जीरो इंटू टूज काउंट हाउ मेनी ऑफ काउंट ऑफ वन. सिंपल सोल्यूशन, देखिए दिस इज माई सोल्यूशन. Okay, here it is. So we'll just count how many of 0 and how many of 1. I will just 2's power 1 into how many of 1. 1 is 1 and Z1 is 2's power how many of 0. And this is the answer. C problem. ओके, सो वी आर जस्ट गिवन अ स्ट्रिंग, दिस इज अ गुड प्रॉब्लम आई थिंक. ओके, वी आर जस्ट गिवन अ स्ट्रिंग, सो वी हैव टू जस्ट, वी कैन इरेज एट मोस्ट वन एलिमेंट, एट मोस्ट वन कैरेक्टर एंड द अकरेंस ऑफ दैट कैरेक्टर. सो वी हैव टू मिनिमाइज द occurrence, we have to minimize the occurrence of a character and we will find which character to be erased, or we have to erase, like we just given a string like a b c d e f or any type of string. So we have to choose any one character, at most one character. If it is already palindrome, then we will just return 0. We don't need to erase anything. And if it is not palindrome, so we need to erase. So if we at most choose any, at most a character and erase the occurrence of this character and check the for the minimum one, we will go for the minimum one. So what is the observation, like if we have this string, okay, like a b b c c a a, okay, and if after erasing some characters, like if we erase some characters of a, like if we, like for a, for any character, after erasing that much, like if this is the answer, like after that erasing that much, answer will be minimum or minimum, then we will say that if we erase all the occurrence of a of that character c, then our string must be palindrome. Yes, because if after erasing that element, like if I erase all occurrence of A, then the string must be palindrome. If it is palindrome, then we can say that like after erasing some occurrence of this character, we get answer. Okay, so we will go for the minimum. That's the simple answer. And after that, what we do? Like if we found that for this character we will get answer, like for a surety, if we get after erasing all the occurrence of that character, if we will get a palindrome, then there is a possibility that we will get answer, like because like a b c c b a, like after erasing a character, लाइक दिस इज द ओरिजिनल पैलिंड्रोम एंड इफ वी रेज दिस वन, सो आफ्टर रेजिंग दिस वन वी विल गेट पैलिंड्रोम एंड आफ्टर वी रेज दिस एंड दिस ऑल्सो देन मस्ट बी द स्ट्रिंग मस्ट बी पैलिंड्रोम. ओके सो वी विल चेक फर्स्ट चेक इफ लाइक फॉर एनी करेक्टर सी इट इज पैलिंड्रोम और नॉट by erasing the all the occurrence of that one, and after we will check what minimum occurrence we have to erase. Okay, so for that one we just go for the two pointer method, a simple two pointer method. Okay, so how we will go, like this is the string, so if we have this is the L, we have this string, complete string, and this is the last character, R. So there are 3 to 4 possibilities. Like if both characters are equal, we just L plus plus, we will increment the L and decrease the R. Okay. Now if it is not equal, then there must be any element. If it is S of L, we are checking for any element. Okay, like I will see your answer once, then you will better understand what I am doing. And this is my solution. Yeah, sure. So what I am doing is I'm checking if this string is palindrome. If it is already palindrome, okay, then I will just return 0. Otherwise I will check for all the characters. Wait a minute. It is okay. This is for checking the filter. So what we given is that we are just taking the string. Oh my god, the string. ओके लेट इट बी डन. ओके सो वी जस्ट चेक फॉर द पैलिंड्रोम लाइक ओके वी चेक फॉर द पैलिंड्रोम एंड देन वी जस्ट गो फॉर चेक फॉर द ईज ऑफ द करेक्टर. ओके लाइक वी विल जस्ट रिमूव ऑल द अकरेंस ऑफ द करेक्टर एंड इफ इट इज पैलिंड्रोम दैट मीन्स वी विल गेट आंसर फ्रॉम दिस. आफ्टर रेजिंग सम ऑफ द अकरेंस और ऑल द अकरेंस वी विल गेट द आंसर. या देन वी विल चेक वट इज द मिनिमम अकरेंस आई हैव टू इरेज एंड आई विल जस्ट कैलकुलेट द मिनिमम ऑफ द आंसर एंड आई विल जस्ट प्रिंट द आंसर. सो आई विल शो यू द चेक फंक्शन दैट विल कैलकुलेट द आंसर. ओके सो दिस इज माई चेक फंक्शन. What I am doing is I am just taking a two point I and J and I am just then there are only two possibilities like if this is equal or this is not equal. Okay and we will here we know that like here we know that only we have to erase C character. Okay we have to only erase the C character then because we already checked the palindrome like if we erase all the occurrence of C then this string is palindrome. So we already checked the palindrome, so this string is palindrome. Okay so we don't have to worry about the other characters, so we have to worry about only this C character. So if it is not equal, if it is equal we just increment or decrement both occurrence. This is bullshit. I'm just so you have not to focus on this. So increase the I and decrease the J. So and after if it is not equal, okay, so if it is not equal then there must be any character which is equal to C, because if we remove all the occurrence of C then string is palindrome and so there must be any character this is C. If this is C, S of I is C, so we just move the other move forward and check for this one if this string is palindrome or not, and if this character is C then we will check for that one. We will just decrease this one and check for this string. Okay and this will increase how many we erase the character that will return CC. Okay yeah, this is the answer. I will just recap this answer at once. So what we do just we check for from I to 26 we will check for all the character we will just remove for checking like we can also do simply, but I prefer to remove all the characters of like for 1 to 26 and check if this string is palindrome. If this string is palindrome then I am sure that after erasing some occurrence of that character I will get the string palindrome. Okay so I for getting the minimum answer I will go for two pointer method. I will just if this is my string like if this is my string okay yeah this is my string then I am just here and here L and R or I or J. So if this is equal I am just increasing both of two elements, and if they are not equal like if they are not equal then I am sure if any of character is like I am checking for this a C character then I have to see that like from both of them which is C character. There must be C character. If this is not C character then string is palindrome. Like okay then I check from both of two element there is one C character. If this is C character I will just increase it here and check for this one for this string if this is palindrome or not, and if it is a C character I am just decrease this one here and check for the character. Yeah this is my solution. Hope you understand. Taking out too much time for this one. Okay so sorry for that. Yeah so we have this is also a simple problem. So what we given, we just given a ए ओ फाइव विच डजन कॉन्टेन जियो. ओके वी जस्ट ए वन ए टू ए थ्री ए फोर ऑल द करेक्टर्स. Okay, so this doesn't contain zero. We have to generate a B array such that product of like a of same length a of a one b one plus a two b like summation of all a will be a I b I will be zero. Okay, so we can understand this is a simple problem. Or we just see that. Like and only one condition is also there that summation of all absolute values of b must be less than or equal to 10 to the power 9. Okay, so we'll see that if we have two elements a1 a2, so what we do is we just take b1 b2, so that's the product will be zero. So what we do is we just take b1 is equal to a2 and this is and b1 is equal to a2 and a1 is equal to b2 and if we interchange their sign, so the value will be a1 b1 and minus a sorry a1 a2 and then the product will be a1 a2 minus a2 a1, then sum will be zero. Okay, so we will do same for this array. So if so we have two cases, if n is odd, if n is even, we just make up pairs. Okay, we just make the pairs of two to each and we will get the solution. And second question, if it is not, if it is odd, so we'll just make all the pairs up till n minus 3 and the remaining is three elements like a n minus 2, a n minus 1 and a of n. We have three elements. Now we have to see that we have three elements and we have to choose another three elements of b such that the product will be zero. So what we will do is we just take here is a3 and a3 and here b3 I will take a1 plus a2. Okay, this is my b1, this is my b2 and this is my b3 and this must be of opposite sign. Okay, so then what will be the summation will be a1 into my a3 plus a2 into a3 minus a1 plus a2 by a3, then also summation is zero. Then also summation is zero. So but we can say that the sum must be also like, yeah, this is correct, but we have to, then there is a possibility that a1 plus a2 will be zero, but we don't have to take a b element is not equal to zero. So we have to check for the all of these, like we just check for a1 plus a2, a2 plus a3 and a1 plus a3, which is whose sum is not zero. We just take that one and we will just calculate for the others. Yeah, we'll take the summation of this one, like if a2 plus a3 is not zero and a1 plus a2 is zero, so what we do is we just take the summation here for a b1 a2 plus a3 and for b2 plus b3 we take a1 a1. Okay, yeah, this is a simple solution. I will just You can see my solution. Yeah, this is my solution. I'm taking a of n and a elements. I will check if it is odd, then I will just make the pairs, like b of I will be a of I plus 1 and b of I plus 1 will be a of I with the opposite sign. Yeah, then this I will make the pair of both 2. I will increase by 2. Yeah. And if it is odd, for up to n minus 3, I will make the I will do the same thing. And for the last 3 elements, I will check the for the sum. Okay, I will check for the sum, which sum is, if a1 is not equal to 0 or a2 is not equal to 0 and else. And you may think also that, like, if both 3 will be 0, then there is no case in which both 3 sum, there is only 3 possibilities, like a1 plus a2 is, then b, there is only 3 possibilities for the 3 elements, like a1 plus a2, b a2 plus a3 and a3 plus a1. In all the 3s, there must be one that is not equal to 0. Why it is so? There is a, you may take any value and there is will be a value in both 3 that is not equal to 0, because if like there is one condition like both 3 are equal, then summation of any 2 is not equal to 0. And if both of 3 are unequal, then there must be a one of the 3 value that is not equal to 0. Okay. So we will check for, I will take all the 3 possibilities and which is not equal to 0, then I will just do the same thing and put that value of a and summation and put the negative of that summation. Yeah, I am just doing the same thing for a1, a2 and just output the b array. Yeah, hope you understand. Then this is the K1, this is also, this is a good program. Okay, so what is given that this is Korni was just experiment with the bitwise ZOR. So what he is doing is that, so we have to check for X element such that if it is possibility that okay, oh, sorry. If there is any increasing subsequence of A in which bitwise ZOR is equal to 0. Okay, so we have to check. Oh, sorry. We have an increasing subsequence of A such that bitwise ZOR is equal to X. Okay, and it is also given that what is an subsequence, like we just delete an increasing subsequence, we just taking the values. Okay, then this is the increasing subsequence of A. Increasing sub, okay, like increasing subsequence, like we adjust 1, 2, 3, 4 or something like that. We adjust and these are the increasing subsequence. Okay, then we just take the ZOR of that. Firstly, I just don't understand the question, like this is that part, like increasing subsequence of A. Increasing subsequence is that we have just take the values of A of I, like then A of I must be greater than, if we have just taking the another A of J or A of K, like any values, three values, 4 values of A. So their values must be increasing. Okay, and if ZOR is equal to X, we will accept that X only. Okay, like then these value must be increasing. Yeah, this is that one. Okay, so what we'll do is, so here it is, we have 500 only, like a of value will be 500. So in 500, there must be only 2's power 9. 2's power 9 is, sorry. Yeah, 2's power 9 is greater than 500. So we have to take only 9 bits. So maximum sum of 9 bits. Okay. Like 8 bits only, 500 will be 8 bits, so maximum sum will be maximum like 600. It will go up to 600, so complexity will be n into 600. Okay, for the hard version it will give the timeout, but it is okay for this one. So what we'll do is, I'm just creating an array, and it is always possible to get 0 element. Okay, for not getting any element, that will be 0. So 0 will be takeable, and I will just take the minimum element. Like if I am getting the jor is x for these elements, like these and they are two subset whose jor is x, and both are increasing. This is also increasing, this is also increasing, like 1 3 7. Here is jor, like this is example. Maybe jor will be not same. Jor is like 9, and another is 1 1 2 6. Jor is 9, so I will take this subarray. Okay, so I have to take care of only the last element. Okay, and I will just minimize the last element. Okay, yeah, this is the solution of that problem. So I'll just iterate over all the values of x, and if I have a of I will be like 4. Okay, so I will just go through all the elements, like up to 600, 1 to 600, and I will check if the last element, like for this, like if array is and jor is 9 for that one, and another, like I will say, like yeah, 9 is no set for this. I will say now I have a of I is 11, and I have two subsets, like this is jor is 10 and this is 9 7, and I will take another one, 1 8 and 12, and jor is something like x. Okay, so I will take care, like I am getting 9 jor, and the value of the last element is less than that one of a of I. Now this is the current a of I. Now if the jor of this one will be increasing subarray. Okay, then up to jor is 9, then I will just take 9 jor 11 will be another subarray. Okay, I will show you one solution, or I have to explain. It is not clear yet. It's a simple problem, like yeah, this is a solution, my solution. Okay, so last minimum element for this, I will just set it to maximum. Firstly, and for 0 it is 0, and it will take care how which element is which x I am taking off. Okay, I'm just for 0 it is 1. For I to n I am taking x element, and for 0 to 6 I am taking for the 0 to 600, and if the minimum for this j will be less than x, then it will be increasing subarray. So next element will be jor of x and jor of j comma x. So I will just set it to true, like this will be the takeable, like I will get this x now, like this x इन इंक्रीजिंग सफर एंड द लास्ट एलिमेंट आई विल जस्ट टेक ऑफ द मिनिमम ऑफ एक्स एंड दिस वन. ओके सो दिस इज व्हाट इज दिस इज ऑफ प्लेनर. व्हाट इज दैट लाइक फर्स्टली आई हैव जीरो. ओके देन आई हैव लाइक ए ऑफ आई इज 1, 5, 7, 9, 3, 2, and 1. So I will see that last element for 0 is 0 and for all other I will take 1, 10 to the power 9. And the taken. Taken will be see that which x I will get. For this is true, for all other is false. This is what we have the initial conditions. Then I will just go for A of I. Then I will take for I will just iterate over this array last minimum. Okay. I will just iterate over this array. So I will see that this A of I is only greater than this one. Zero. So will next element will be 1, 0, 0. So element will be 1. Next element will be 1. So I will just say that last minimum of next element will be 1, will be minimum of last element, that is L of 1, comma, now this is will be my last element will be 1. Then L of 1 is also said to be 1. Okay. Then I will just go for the second value. For the 5, I am here now. For the 5, I am just look at, yeah, this is also true. Like last of 0 is less than 5. Okay, for the increasing subsequence. Then the next element will be, or now element will be 5, 0, 0. Will be 5. And the minimum of 5 is, minimum of 5 is also, or I will say, last of 5 will be 5. Okay. Last of 5 will be 5. Similarly, right, in the similar fashion, I will just go through all these. Like, what we are just doing in a simple manner, like, one we will get if we have, if in array I have 1, so I will get only, if I will choose only this element, then I will get 1. Okay. And then I will choose any of the element. Okay. Like 1 is gettable for the last element is 1. If I am just getting 5, then 1, 0, 5 is 4. Then 4 will be, I will get 4 of 1 and 0 of 1 and 5. Okay, I will just then go for the 7. Then the last element for the 4 is 5. Then I will take 0 of 4, because these elements 0 is 4 and the last for the 4 is 5. So we have to only take care of the last element. Okay, yeah, this is my code. Hope you understand. Then I will count how many of is true and that which one is true is, I will just output the answer. Okay, yeah. Hope you understand. Thanks a lot.